the lake monster of Lake Varg, a hideous creature that slinks through the water devouring whatever creatures he can find. A monstrous creature.
Well, in his defense, he is technically a monster.
Why are you defending him?
Let's just say I know what it's like to be a misunderstood miscreant mired in melancholy.
Nice alliteration.
Thank you. Nice assonance.
I'm not getting anywhere near that monster. I've seen what he does to anything that falls in.
I call him Inky, but Shrouty called him Mr. Body Disposal.
Hello, Mr. Lake Monster. I think you are so glossy and shiny and powerful looking. I bet you're just misunderstood and not monstrous at all.
What are you trying to do? Make a new friend or something?
Did it ever occur to you that once we find a way out of this castle, we're probably going to end up encountering that creature? What if it ends up that he's hungry and he decides he wants to eat one of us? At that point, is he more likely to choose the friendly, young woman or the annoying little bat who's always being mean to him?
Hey, Lake Monster, you rock! Buddy old pal of mine, you rule!
It's the shoreline of Lake Varg. I have to find a way to escape this damnable castle so that I can get over there and back to Peli.
Why don't you fly over there again? I know it's kind of far, but I think we could make it.
For some reason, I can't fly over moving water. It must be part of the magic curse Shrouty placed on me.
Curse, huh? Does the name of this so-called curse rhyme with Zampire?
Look, the lake shore is so close it feels like you could reach out and touch it.
If you want to touch the shore so badly, I could fly over there, get some of it, and bring it back for you.
Better yet, maybe you should just shut up and help me escape from this castle. How about that?
Hey, is anybody over there? We're stuck in this castle. If you can hear my voice, please bring over a large boat. Maybe a ladder and some lake monster repellent. And if it's not too much of an inconvenience, can you pick up a roasted chicken and a mug of grog?
Don't you think the grog was pushing it a bit?
Hey, sometimes you gotta swing for the fence.
It's a stone gargoyle. Short and ugly.
Kind of reminds me of Shrouty.
I know Shrouty hid the key in one of these gargoyles. I just can't remember which one.
Guess we're gonna have to search all of them.
I can't move it. If the key's inside, I'm not going to be able to pry it out with my hands.
This looks like the perfect time to inflict a little blunt force trauma.
Now, Mr. Gargoyle, would you please be so kind as to give me the key that Shrouty has hidden inside of you? Pretty please, with sugar on top? I bet I could provoke the gargoyle that has the key by smashing them all with that mace.
Hey, that's not half bad, and it will be extremely fun. Let's do it. Looks like our favorite lake monster has a serious case of acid reflux disease.
Whatever that is, it sounds painful.
Inky needs to stop eating so much Italian.
Oh, like lasagna or pizza?
No, Italians. Like the boat full of Venetian tourists that he sank yesterday.
Aha! Looks like we found the enchanted gargoyle.
The name is Rufus Thaddeus Worthington IV. Not enchanted gargoyle, a walking corpse and rat with wings.
Frederick, what is he talking about?
Later. Well, Rufus, this corpse and rat just made you lose your cool and blow your cover. How do you like them apples, Worthington?
What a tremendous accomplishment. Perhaps we should have a moment of silence to honor you and your magnificent deeds.
Not had the mace anymore, but I've still got my fists.
Mr. Gargoyle, prepare to receive the contents of the oversized barrel of whoop butt that Mona is about to open on you.
I'll not lower myself to engage in fisticuffs with an undead hussy or a tick-infested rat.
Tick? Where? I thought I ate them all this morning.
How dare you? I am no hussy.
Your proportions say otherwise.
You don't care for the classic hourglass shape, eh? I hear ya. I'm a more Rubenesque bat myself, but sometimes...
Frederick, what are you doing?
Hey, you can't talk to my friend like that no matter how over-proportioned she is. That better?
Loads. Please, I feel as though we've started off on the wrong foot. Or in your case, perhaps the wrong claw. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Mona de Lafitte.
Charmed, I'm sure. I don't usually associate with common folk such as yourself. As you appear to be a lady, I would consider kissing your hand, but based on the smell of you, I must conclude that you are clearly a member of the unwashed masses.
You certainly are an unpleasant creature.
You would be unpleasant too if you endured what I have.
Like what? Tell me your story.
Oh, very well. Many years ago, the Baroness von Kiefer created me in her workshop. Apparently, the Baron's death left the castle a bit on the lonely side. After my creation, I was allowed to reside in the library. The Baroness and I would spend hours talking, and in my free time, I was given full access to the Von Kiefer Library. During the day, I would spend hours upon hours educating myself and feasting upon literary delicacies such as Shakespeare, Chaucer, and Milton. A most enjoyable experience, I assure you.
I understand perfectly. I'm curious, how did you end up on this bridge?
The Baroness decided she wanted to have a child.
A child? Who was the father? You?
No. I assure you, no child of mine would turn out like Shroudy. And if it did, I would have thrown him into the lake.
That would seriously impact your chances of getting one of those World's Greatest Dad coffee mugs.
No, truth be told, I don't know who Shroudy's father is. All I know is that the Baroness disappeared into her workshop. There were some strange sounds. Then the crying of a child. I can't imagine what went on down there. Your guess is as good as mine on the origin of that alien.
Stop right there. I don't want to know.
Oh, don't be absurd.
Good. I didn't want that image in my head. The Baroness of this castle?
Yes. Before Shroudy ruled here, the Baroness Lilith von Kiefer was in charge.
So then you and she...
Oh, don't be absurd.